Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, bismillah, walhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Dear brothers and sisters, supporters of the Positive Islamic Psychology model, welcome again to this series. This is your host, Gabriel Romani. Hope you guys are doing well. Sisters, brothers, wherever you all are, all over the world. We're continuing with the influence of inner speech. And we talked about how important that is. Let us look at how that works as a conditioning system. So we said that if people are not aware of how it works, and it is unconscious, obviously people cannot benefit from it or use it towards their development. It could happen that you just get conditioned and you don't even know it, right? So even for a person who has a good knowledge and understanding of the laws of learning, it remains difficult to be aware of the subtleties of the internal conditioning process. So we said before in the previous episode that the external conditioning process and the internal are both very, very important. This would mean that the laws of learning must become part of our life, part of our being, as we are already one with the laws of learning. We need only become aware of our true nature, which is the second principle that we talked about, right, out of the four principles. And we will come to the full realization of principles of learning. You understand now, brothers and sisters, why is it so important to have a proper system of education? Why those who wanted to corrupt Islam and who wanted to attack Islam have infiltrated our educational systems in the Muslim Ummah? We were the leaders of the educational system at a time where the Western world was not even thinking about education. We were the ones who put Al-Hamra together. We were the ones who put Al-Qarawain together. We were the ones who put the greatest universities and knowledge hubs in the world before people were even thinking about that. But the problem is that those who wanted to take it down, they knew exactly where to pin and infiltrate. And that is why I, as a school principal, as a counselor, teacher, I always encourage governments, maybe you brothers and sisters will be the next ones, who will go back to the grassroots level and bring our own learning systems, our own curriculums developed based on the Quran, Sunnah, and Islamic principles. And keeping in mind the laws of learning, okay? Which will benefit, inshallah, and will help us to develop what we talked about, the Khalifah model, right? The individual, the family, the society, the larger society, the world, that internal change will continue to produce righteous individuals, helping the Muslims develop and helping the non-Muslims to come to Islam. Let's talk now about modeling and human behavior. Modeling is a form of conditioning. It is what the teachers do, best practices. It is what actors and everyone do. Monkey see, monkey do, we said in the book. And that refers to the tendency of people to imitate behavior of others. And that is why, basically, modeling involves learning by seeing. That is why the Sunnah of the Prophet is so, so important. That is why we keep saying Quran and Sunnah, Quran and Sunnah. Okay, the Prophet when asked, well, Aisha was asked, and she said, "Kana khuluquhu al-Quran." His behavior was the Quran. The Sahabas used to be with him. See, and that's why they're so successful. That's why the Prophet said, "The best generation is my generation." They were with the Prophet. They saw the Prophet showing best practices, modeling how they should be. We are now taking the theory and it's been passed over generations. And a lot of us are stuck in the theory. But this model that we're trying to tell here is that we need to transform theory into practice, right? Because if not, well, look what the world is doing. The world is doing that. For example, smoking, okay? The influence of modeling on smoking behavior are many, okay? You have the media, entertainment industry, pop models, behavior of those who have, you know, never been seen in person, but through technology is reaching to us. And remember, the laws of learning, it's conditioning us, and we don't even know. We're just sitting in the back of our couch watching our little videos here and there, and we're being conditioned. Movie stars, television, music world, people seeing smoking, so modeling is occurring. And our children, young adults, are being exploited by this and affected by this because they see, wow, these successful people have so many likes, followers, and so on. If I want to be successful, this is the way to go. And that is why it is so dangerous.